Having finished our back four last week, this week we move on to the seven greatest defensive midfielders of all time. In this series, we're going to split central midfielders into defensive and attacking. Naturally, some midfield players, particularly box-to-box types, may not fall into either of those categories. So some players you may not traditionally consider primarily attacking or defensive have had to be qualified as one or the other in this series. This was a really tricky seven, and even if it was a top 77 rather than seven, there'd still be some incredible talent that would have to miss out. Here are our seven greatest defensive midfielders of all time. Ernst Ockwerk. We start with a player who may not be too familiar to younger viewers, but he deserves to be in ahead of more recent stars like Andrea Pirlo and Edgar Davids. Unfortunately, we only have one picture of Ockwerk, so you may have to get used to it. A 6-foot central midfielder who could do it all, Ockwerk spent much of his career as a classic centre-half pivot, where he would use his brilliant reading of the game and aerial ability to snuff out the opposition. He would be a perfect modern-day defensive midfielder though, with his fantastic range of passing and ability on the ball. Ockwerk played for Austria Vienna, Sampdoria and the Austrian national team. The English nicknamed him Clockwork, partly due to his name and partly because he always kept the Austrian national team ticking over. Roy Keane. When it comes to Premier League players, you could make a case for the likes of Paul Scholes, Patrick Vieira and Claude Makélélé, but Keane is the only one to feature in our seven. A criminally underrated footballer who has become better known for his hard man image than his footballing talents, Keane was the driving force in an all-conquering Manchester United team. A brilliant leader and a born winner, Keane was also a superb footballer who rarely misplaced a pass. His performance in Manchester United's 1999 Champions League semi-final win against Juventus, in which he almost single-handedly bossed a midfield containing the likes of Zinedine Zidane, Edgar Davids, Didier Deschamps and Antonio Conte, summed him up. Johan Neeskens. Dutch football's second most famous Johan, poor old Johan Neeskens, played alongside the more famous Johan at Ajax, Barcelona and with the Dutch national team. A truly sensational footballer, he was the engine room of Holland's total football. A really complete player, Neeskens was versatile, tireless, and technically excellent. He could play as a box-to-box player, a defensive midfielder, or even at right back. He won 3 European Cups with Ajax, and reached 2 World Cup finals with the Netherlands, as well as winning a variety of other trophies in Holland, Spain, and the United States. Lothar Matthäus. There have been few finer defensive midfielders in the history of the game than Lothar Matthäus. A quite brilliant midfielder who enjoyed extraordinary longevity, he spent 20 years as a German international, winning 150 caps. Diego Maradona described him as the best rival he ever had, and Matthäus played in 5 World Cups, making 25 appearances. He won the tournament in 1990 and finished as a runner-up in 1982 and 1986. Another midfield all-rounder, Matthäus was a hard-working, intelligent and tough-tackling midfielder with an eye for a pass. He was named German Footballer of the Year at the age of 38, and he is the only German to have been named FIFA World Player of the Year. Frank Rijkaard. Whilst we are talking about complete players, it would be rude not to move on to Frank Rijkaard. An absolute midfield titan, he had incredible physical attributes, being able to use his size, strength and speed to great effect. He was also a magnificent footballer, who was elegant on the ball, could read the game masterfully, and had a brilliant understanding with his teammates. Rijkaard was part of 3 brilliant teams, namely Ajax, AC Milan, and the Dutch national team. Jozef Bożyk. We wouldn't argue with anyone who suggested that Jozef Bożyk was the greatest central or defensive midfielder of all time. Indeed, every player in this seven had incredible ability, and Bożyk was a real class act. The glue which held Hungary's golden team together, some Hungarians consider him, and not Ferenc Puskas, to have been their greatest ever player. Physically, he was a million miles away from someone like Rijkaard, but he had incredible stamina, an unerring ability to read the game, and could spot a pass most couldn't see from the stands. The best passer of a ball in this seven, Bożyk is an all-time great, and ought to have won the World Cup with Hungary in 1954. Jose Andrade. Defensive midfielders can be the unsung heroes of many great sides, quietly going about their business whilst more attacking players take the headlines. Well, not Jose Andrade. Despite being a defensive midfielder, in his prime, he was regarded as the finest footballer on the planet. The son of an escaped Brazilian slave, who was reportedly 98 years old when Jose was born, he had a tough start to life, but in 1924, he became a global superstar. Uruguay headed to the Olympic Games, unknown to Europeans, and proceeded to walk their way to a gold medal. In a team of superstars, Andrade still stood out. Pulling the strings like a puppet master in midfield, he was quick, strong, and technically perfect. The press nicknamed him the Black Marvel, and he went on to win 3 Copa Americas, 2 Olympic golds, and 1 World Cup. For our money at least, he is the greatest defensive midfielder of all time. So that's it for our top 7. So many outstanding players missed out that it's almost futile trying to name any honourable mentions. But we'll give it a go anyway. The likes of Matias Sama, Mario Coluna, Luis Monti, Andrea Pirlo, Obdulio Varela, and Edgar Davids all came close. Thanks for watching, give us a like if you enjoyed the video, and don't forget to subscribe to HITC Sevens.